Now we'll look at two limits at infinity involving the exponential function with base e. We first have the limit as x approaches infinity of 3 divided by the quantity e raised to the power of x minus 3. So we first want to determine what's happening to e to the power of x as x approaches infinity. Well, we're raising e to larger and larger positive powers, and therefore e to the x would be approaching positive infinity. So as x approaches infinity, the numerator stays at 3, but the denominator increases without bound. Well, any fraction where the numerator is fixed and the denominator increases without bound is always going to approach 0, and therefore this limit is equal to 0. This limit should remind us of the limit given here below that we use when determining limits of rational functions, where we have the limit as x approaches infinity of c divided by x raised to the power of r equals 0 when r is a positive rational number and c is any real number. The idea was the same. If the numerator is a fixed value and the denominator increases without bound, that limit is going to equal 0, for the same reason why this limit here is equal to 0. Now let's take a look at a second example. Notice how the function is the same, but now we have the limit as x approaches negative infinity. So to determine this limit, we want to figure out what's happening to e to the power of x as x approaches negative infinity. Well, now we have e being raised to smaller and smaller negative exponents, and therefore e to the x is going to approach 0. It might be easier to see this if we write e to the power of x as 1 divided by e to the negative x. Remember, if we write this over 1 and then move this across the fraction bar, it would change the sign of the exponent. So we can write this if we want to as a limit as x approaches negative infinity of 3 divided by 1 divided by e to the negative x minus 3. In this form, it might be easier to see that 1 divided by e to the negative x as x approaches negative infinity would be approaching 1 divided by larger and larger numbers, because now we're raising e to positive powers. So this term here kind of fits this form here. So this fraction approaches 0. Therefore, this limit is going to be equal to the constant 3 divided by the constant negative 3, which is equal to negative 1. And since both of these limits exist, if we graph our function, we should have two horizontal asymptotes, one at y equals 0 and one at y equals negative 1. So let's finish by taking a look at our graph. Here's a graph of our function. Notice as x approaches positive infinity, the function values are approaching 0. And as x approaches negative infinity, the function values are approaching negative 1. So this graph verifies our limit, as well as that we have two horizontal asymptotes, one of y equals 0 and one of y equals negative 1. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.